Hello, welcome to this channel Gain Java Knowledge, and today in this video we are going to learn how to write code more sophisticated and readable. Because sometimes having your code full of if else and is not the exact right way to let your colleagues to understand it. So as a beginner or even if you are quite good at your job, should make your code more sophisticated and readable. So to make our code more readable, the first thing we need to try to remove if else in your code. So here first I will remove all the if else condition from my this block of code. So here we can see there are multiple lines of code, but after removing all the if else condition, it will be two or three lines of code will be left. So let me go to our IntelliJ and here I will just declare main method. And after that I will just paste the same code here. So inside this code we can see we have multiple conditions that we have added inside one function, that is valid. So if is valid function will start to execute, first it will check condition is not equal to null. After that it will check if condition equals to high. After that it will assign the response, that is boolean value, to our variable result. If it is not equals or not matching this condition, then it will go to else block and then it will assign false. And if this condition is not matching and we are getting condition equal to equal to null, then it will go directly inside this else block. And in that case, it will return false. So we can reduce these lines of code by just removing multiple if else. So what we can do, we can just remove this variable and we can use early return. So early return is also a good approach to remove multiple or if else conditions that we have added in our code. So let me use early return approach. So here we will remove this boolean, and if condition is not equal to null and condition is equal to high, in that case we just need to return true. So here I will just return true, and in another approach we will just return false. So here we no need to add multiple if else. So this three lines of code is also equal to these lines of code that we have showing here. So let me copy this again. So go back to here, and here I will just return false. So here I will paste this also, and I will give name is valid 2. So let me run this code and test our functions. So here just I will copy and create the instance of this class. Test dot is valid function, and here I will pass the same condition high, and let me copy the same line and will call is valid to function here. So inside is valid we can see multiple lines of code, but inside is valid there is only three lines. So let me run and execute this application, and we'll see both lines of codes are working, both functions are working same. So here we can see there we are getting result as true from both the functions. So here if I will change the condition high to, so in that scenario we will also get the same response, that will be false. So here we can see we are getting false. Responses are same from both the functions, but lines of codes are different. Here we can see lines of code 2, 3, 4, 5. But here we can see multiple if else conditions are available inside this function. So we can reduce by using this early return condition. So early return, this approach is generally only suitable for simple structure, and we can return early to get rid of some of the unnecessary if else conditions. And after early return, there is another approach that we can use, enumeration and optional, and there is table driven approaches also available. So now we can see how we can use enumeration to reduce the lines of code and to make our code more readable. And so let me go to IntelliJ back. So this was our first approach, that is early return, that we can use to make our code more readable. And now we will go for second approach, that is enumeration. So first we will check without enumeration. So here I have just added one method, that is getLabel. So if I want to call this method, so here I will call this function from here, test.getLabel, and here I will pass some int value, that is 1, and we can just print this value. So I will copy this. So here inside getLabel we can see there are multiple if, else if, else if, else if conditions are available, and code is not looking more readable. And if we are passing value label as a 1 from here, once it will be exactly matched, after that it will assign response to our label variable, and in the last it will return the label. So if I will run this application, we will get padding as a output. So how we can reduce these lines of code by using enumeration? So without enumeration, we can see we are getting response as padding. So let me change the code and we'll use the enumeration. So here I will add one enum, new Java class, and here I will select enum, and here we just need to give the name to our enum class. So here I have given the name, that is status label enum, and here I will give the annotation @getter, because we just need getter method, and @all_arg constructor. So these two are required. So here I have added. So here let me add two variable, private int status, and second I will just add private string label, because based on status we need to get the label value. So here I will just add. So here I will just declare these four values that we have added here. One is label 1 for padding, label 2 for paid, label 3 for success, and label 4 for failed. So maybe you could say no one write code like this, but actually this is quite common. So this type of code is well suited for enumeration to solve. So let me go back to our enumeration class, and here I will just declare these four values, padding, and it's 1 for padding and 2 for paid, and the third value we have declared is success. So 3 for success, and we have added fourth value is failed. So 4 will be for failed. Now we need one function that will return label based on our status value that we are passing. So here I will declare one function, public string static string get label by status. And here I will just pass integer value of status. So what I will do here, first I will iterate this enumeration enum, status label enum, and we can give any name, label enum, and here we just need to use the value status label enum dot values. So here we are just iterating all the values. And here I will add one condition. So if label enum dot get status will exactly matching to the status that we are passing as a parameter, then we will return its label value. So here we will return label enum dot get label. So here we will just return the same value. In another case, we will just return unknown, or we can return any value. So here we have created enum. So let me go to my code back and we'll use the enum and we will remove these lines of codes. So let me remove this. And here I will go back and just copy the name of this enum. And here we just need to call this enum from here. And the function name is get label by status. So here I am just passing the 1. So let me call this function and we'll check the output. We will just get the padding as a response. So here we can see the one line of code is enough. So here we no need to line multiple lines of codes. So here we are getting padding as a response. So of course in the actual project this way of handling is not the best. The best way should be in the database. There is a key value configuration table we have need to create. So enumeration is also a simple solution if the status is fixed. This will not increase in future. So we can go with this approach, enumeration. And the next is optional. So optional is also a best approach to make our code more readable and handle null pointers. So I am sure you guys have project where there is a known null judgment, and if it is null, then we are throwing exception or also returning some response. So let me go to IntelliJ and see how we can use this approach. So let me go with third approach, that is optional. But for this approach, let me create one more entity class, or we can say model class. So here I will give just employee, because we are not communicating with DB. So I will just create one model class. And here I will declare three properties, private int ID, private string name, and also I will private int status. And for this I will just use @data and @all our constructor annotation. So no need to write any setter or getter methods because we have added @data annotation, and no need to create any parameterized constructor because here I have added @all our constructor. So let me go back to our test class, and here I will just add one function. So for this function I will just create one method because here we are not using any repository layer. So here I will declare the same method inside our class, and from here I will just return new employee, and here I will pass ID, name and status. Status like 4 for padding, 4 for failed. So here I have just passed one integer value. So this is a method that we have written here, get status. So from here I will just call the same method. So first, before using optional, how we can use, and we can see here. So here I will call get status, and here I will just pass integer value 1. So here I have just added one employee. Its employee ID is 1 and name is name and status is 4. And here I am calling the function with same status ID as a 1. So once it will call this get employee by ID, we will get one employee object and if employee is equal to null, it will return 1. Otherwise, we will get the status from our response from our object that we have added. So let me run this application. So here we can see we have added if else conditions, but we can also reduce this else condition from our code also, or we will remove it. So once we will check without optional, so here we are getting the response and status is 4 that we are expected. So let me go and see how we can remove this if else condition from our code. So to remove this if else condition, we can use optional. So how we can use? So first I will use, so remove these lines, or we can comment, and here we can just return optional dot nullable. Of nullable function we can use, and here we can pass our employee object, and we will map it, and here we will get employee employees our class model class that we have created, get order status. So here we will use or else. If we are not getting, in that case what we can do, we will just return 1. So this is the code that we can use instead of this if else condition. So in single line we have handled. So let me run this code again and we'll check the output again. So here we can see we are getting the same output, false false, padding and response is 4 while using optional approach. So these are the three ways that we can use to reduce if else or remove the if else code from our project. And one more approach is here, that is table driven approach, that we can also use to remove if else condition from our project. To implement this approach, we need to use interface, and we need to create implementation classes for this interface. So let me go back and we'll see how to use table driven approach in our project to reduce if else condition. So this will be the fourth approach that we can use, table driven approach, that we can also use to remove if else condition. So in which code we need to use this table driven approach? So this is a code like we have added multiple conditions. So here we need to create do action method in test, and here I will just print system.out.println calling do action one method one method, and like this we can create one more function that is doAction2 in the same class. So here I will just print the same. So here I will just do the changes, doAction2 method. So here I have created one method that is print action data, and inside this I have added if else conditions. So if this condition will match, then this function will execute. If this condition will match, then second method will execute. So like this we can add 5 or 10 methods in the same function print action data, but here I am just adding 2. So first let me call this method before adding table driven approach. So this approach was without table driven. So if I want to call this method, so here I will go. So these methods are void. So let me just call test.print action data, and we no need to pass anything. We will need to pass action code 1. So this method is not returning, so I will just remove system.out.println because we have added the statement inside our functions do action 1 and do action 2. So if code 1 condition will match, then do action 1 will execute. If code 2 will match, then do action 2 will execute. But in our case, code 1 we are passing, so our do action 1 will execute. So here inside do action 1 we have printed calling do action 1 method. So let me go and see here. We are just getting the expected response here. So how we can remove this if else condition with the help of table driven approach? So let me see. So what we need to do, we need to create one interface and multiple implementation classes. So first here I will just create new class or new interface, that is action service. So inside this method from interface I will just create one method, that is void type do action, and here I will just pass. So here we no need to pass any parameter. So do action I have declared inside our interface. So let me create implementation class for this interface, Java class. So here I will create action service IMPL 1, and this class will extend or implement action service interface. So now we need to add implemented methods. So here I will just add, and here we need to print the statement. So I will just copy the same statement that we have pasted here, copy from here, paste it here. So we can say do action method 1. So like this we can just copy this and create one more implementation class, and we can give name as 2. And here I will just do action 2 method. So here I have just updated the statement. So let me go back to my test class, and now we will use this code. And let me comment this code, and we'll use table driven approach, and we'll see how to use table driven approach, and we'll also comment this code. And here we need to use map, and inside map I will add same conditions code 1 and code 2. So here I have just declared one map, and inside map I have just added action service 1 and action service 2. So this is action service IMPL 1, and here I have added action service IMPL 2. So here I have added these two inside our map, and here I will just pass the action like code 1. So inside code 1 what we have declared, this statement will be printed on the console. So let me clear this console, and now I will execute it again. So let me run this again. So this is a table driven approach that we can use, but for this approach we must need to use interfaces and its implementation classes. So here we can see we are getting the response calling method do action. So these are the four approaches that we can use to make our code more readable and understandable. So these are the only four ways that we can use to remove if else from our project. So thanks for watching this video.